What's happening? Lee Hayward here. And today, I'm going to do the final video in my 30-day shred challenge. And I just want to give you a summary of how the whole 30 days went. Obviously, by the time you're watching this video, we're well past the whole 30-day thing. And I did not hit my goal. Just come out front and say it like it is. I failed at hitting my goal of losing 10 pounds in 30 days. Now, I thought I was on track. I was very close. And actually, last week, while I was in Toronto, I weighed myself at the hotel gym, and I was actually 192 on the scale at the hotel gym. And I thought, you know what? I've hit my goal. I actually surpassed my goal, because my goal was to get down to 193. And I said, yeah, I surpassed the goal. But I wasn't going to let myself get too excited, because that wasn't the scale that I was monitoring my progress on all along. And of course, different scales may be different, you know, like, you know, make you weigh heavier or lighter or whatever. So I said, I'm going to wait until I get home, until I do my official weigh-in. So I got home, did the official weigh-in, and came in 194 on the dot. So I missed it by technically 0.2 pounds. So I failed in losing 10 pounds in 30 days, but guess what? I ended up hitting that goal within 40 days. There's a lesson here. I'm actually glad that I didn't do it, because it just goes to show that even though you set yourself a goal, very often you're not going to hit the goal exactly, but it's going to propel you in the right direction. And then if you keep moving forward, keep making progress, eventually you'll get to the goal. It may take longer. You may have to take a different approach or whatever, but you can still get there. And that's what I did. So I still got there. I still lost the 10 pounds that I was looking for, but it just took longer than 30 days, which in the greater scheme of things, who cares, right? I mean, it's not like there was some magical deadline other than the fact that I was making a YouTube series about this, but it worked out good, because it's a valuable lesson. Because a lot of people set these goals for themselves, whatever it is, you know, you want to lose so much body fat, gain so much muscle, and even though you're probably making progress, if you have these unrealistic expectations, you can sometimes set yourself up for disappointment, when in reality, you should be setting yourself up for victory, still giving yourself a pat on the back for making progress, right? Don't get hung up on the whole perfection mindset, or get hung up on the actual number. Focus on making progress. That's what matters the most. So I'll give you an example that we can probably all relate. Let's say, you know, a student in school has a goal to get an A+ on a test, and they study, they bust their ass, they work really hard, and they end up getting an A-. Right? They could beat themselves up and say, oh, I failed to hit my goal. I wanted an A+, I got an A-, and get all upset. But guess what? You still got an A-. That's a heck of a lot better than flunking the test. I mean, you still made progress. Now, take the lessons learned and go back to the drawing board and work on improving for the next time. But don't beat yourself up just because you fall short of your goal. Right? It's still progress. It's still a victory. It's still something you can chalk up as a win if you take it in the right context. And that's what I did. So in my case, I just kept working on the program, kept following through, and I ended up hitting my goal of 10 pounds in 40 days. Big deal, right? Made the progress that I wanted to. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to share the workouts that I was doing. I'm actually in the process of getting those workouts edited and, you know, put together into a whole training series, because I was doing a push-pull leg split when I was at the gym, and when I wasn't at the gym, I was doing some bodyweight circuits. So I'm going to put together the workout videos that I was following, and I'm going to share some nutrition tips, you know, outlining the different nutrition strategies that I was following, because even though I wasn't following a strict diet, I did have strategies in place that allowed me to stay on track, satisfy my cravings, get that eating satisfaction that I wanted with high volume, nutrient dense foods, while optimizing my metabolism and burning body fat without being overly strict, overly restrictive, and still enjoying the process. And that's the key. You have to enjoy the process when it comes to fitness and fat loss. If you don't, you're not going to stick with it for the long term, and it's ultimately all for naught. I mean, how many people do you know who go on a diet, lose a bunch of weight, and then something happens, either they run out of willpower, some life situation happens, whatever, they get off track, and then they gain all the weight back again, and now they're back to square one. I mean, chances are, you've probably done it yourself. If you struggle with your weight, you've probably been through this yourself. I know I have. I've been through yo-yo dieting, ups and downs, numerous times over the years. Most of the time, it was related back to my bodybuilding competition days, where I would go on these strict, extreme, pre-contest cutting diets, and then afterwards I would just end up binging after the show and put all the weight that I lost back on again. So it was, I mean, basic, for lack of a better word, it was an eating disorder, right? I'd go through the extremes of ups and downs, and of course in the process it just messed with me mentally, messed with me physically. And I mean, yeah, okay, I go on this crazy strict cutting diet, lose all my excess body fat and look good for the contest, look good for the photos and all that, but it wasn't healthy, it wasn't sustainable, and it certainly wasn't no lifestyle approach. And that's what I'm focusing on right now, is how can I take the core principles that I learned through years of bodybuilding and actually apply it to a lifestyle approach that I can use and maintain, and not just some quick fix, you know, get ripped and then binge and balloon back up again afterwards, because that doesn't serve anything. I mean, it does serve a point from a competition point of view, because you can still compete, you know, look good on stage or look good for your photo shoot or whatever, but if you're doing this for health and fitness, that doesn't work, right? Losing weight temporarily only to gain it all back again, it's a waste, right? What are you doing it for? So my focus has changed substantially, right? It's no longer about that quick fix, get ripped for a contest. It's about how to make this a healthy lifestyle that I can maintain and enjoy. That's the key, maintain and enjoy. And you know, since I've done this whole 30-day shred, I've gotten a lot of emails from people who were asking for help on how they can do the same. And it really got me thinking, you know, what makes an effective fitness and nutrition program? And it's not the how-to. You know, it's not what exercises do I need to do. It's not what foods do I need to eat, or how many calories, or any of that stuff. I mean, yes, that is important. Don't get me wrong. I mean, that is important. But it goes beyond the how-to. Because there's enough how-to information out there as it is. I mean, we are bombarded with how-to. I mean, go on YouTube, right? Search in workouts and you will get, you know, a million workout videos. You go on YouTube, search in nutrition or fat loss or whatever, you'll get a million fat loss videos. Go on Amazon, there's a million diet and exercise books. There's no shortage of how-to information. What there is a shortage of is how to take that information and actually apply it and have it fit within your lifestyle. So there's a shortage of the inner game, right? Not the physical mechanics of what to do, but how to take that, implement it in your lifestyle, and enjoy the process. And that's the key thing that I keep coming back to. If you do not enjoy the process, you will not stick to it for the long term, and ultimately it's just going to backfire and blow up in your face, because you know, you can't run on willpower forever. You have to make this like an automatic thing that you do and enjoy, and it's just part of your regular day-to-day life. And there are ways to go about it. So what I'm thinking about doing, and let me know if you'd be interested in coming on board with this, but I'm thinking about putting together a free 5-day challenge that's really going to go deep into the inner game of fitness and nutrition and how to make this a lifestyle. So if you'd like to come on board, you know, specifically if you're a man who wants to lose that gut, build muscle, get back in shape, and ultimately feel more confident about how your body looks and feels, then send me an email, leeh@leehayward.com, and put the words 5DC in the subject line. 5-day challenge. And that's what I'm going to do. It's going to go an in-depth 5-day challenge where we're really going to focus on the inner game and the mindset that goes behind fitness and nutrition, so that you not only get yourself in shape, but you learn how to maintain it as a lifestyle approach. So if you'd like to be a part of this, send me an email, leeh@leehayward.com, and if I get enough interest, I'll actually go ahead and put this thing out there. Now, of course, if there's not enough interest, then I won't. I'm not going to waste my time if I get like two people want to do it. But if there's enough people, I'll go ahead and put this thing out there, and we'll create a community where we can really focus on this and help you move yourself in the right direction towards reaching your fitness and fat loss goals and maintaining it as your new healthy lifestyle. So there, with that being said, send me an email if you're interested, and stay tuned for some more videos coming soon, and I'll talk to you later. Take care. Over and out.